So good afternoon. Good afternoon. Good
Good afternoon,
afternoon,
sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon,
So in previous class, we have discussed about osteoarthritis and
osteoporosis.
Porosis. So our next topic is osteomyelitis. Do you know about osteomyelitis? Anyone of you?
Inflammation of bone.
Bone. So osteo and what do you mean by myelitis? Two word is there, osteo and myelo. What do you mean by osteo and what do you mean by myelo? And this is nothing but an inflammation. So inflammation to both bone and marrow. This is called as osteomyelitis. Okay, so myelitis is osteo is bone and myelo is marrow. Okay, this is osteomyelitis. Nellanton at 1834, he has given the name osteomyelitis. The root word is osteon, that is called as a bone, and myelo is nothing but a marrow. They are combined, and the tis, which is their third name, it is there, osteomyelitis. So that is a inflammation, which is caused by or which is infected by a microorganism. In introduction, the osteomyelitis is a inflammatory of the bone caused by infecting organism. You can just see the picture where you can find in the bony structure there will be an infection in the bony region. It remain localized or it may spread through the bone to involve the marrow, cortex or peristinium, and mostly it will be localized in the soft tissue surrounded by the bone. So osteomyelitis is nothing but a inflammation to the bone and marrow, which is caused by the infecting organism. So classification are based on the duration and the type of symptom, the mechanism of the infection, and the type of the host response. According to that, they have classified into three mainly. So osteomyelitis. So based on the duration and the type of symptom, if it is based on if there is a acute condition, so it will be less than 2 weeks. There will be a early acute condition will be there, and later condition will be called as a 4 to 5 days, which is early condition to 2 weeks below. In that they have defined as early acute and late acute. Then they have classified as a subacute, where 2 weeks to 6 weeks will be considered as a subacute condition, where there will be a less infection will be there, and there will be a more immunity will be there. And in chronic condition, it will be up to more than after 6 weeks, it will be called as a chronic osteomyelitis. So classified according to the mechanism. So mostly osteomyelitis may be exogenous or hematogenous. So exogenous, like if you see the trauma, surgery, or any contagious infection. Hematogenous, it may be due to a bacteremia. So the types of host response is, it may be in infant, mostly a Staphylococcus aureus. It is the most commonest one. So some other Streptococcus pyogenes, and Streptococcus is a common organism which is found in a osteomyelitis. So single pathogenic organism, this will be considered as a hematogenous osteomyelitis. Multiple organism, direct continuous focal infection, and it will be due to a bacterial. So most common pathogens is Staphylococcus aureus. This is a gram-negative bacilli. Anaerobic organism are also frequently isolated. Staphylococcus aureus is a most commonest cause for osteomyelitis. The prevalence of the Staphylococcus aureus infection is also decreasing nowadays, from 55% to 35% over the 20 years time period. So it was previously 55%, and nowadays it will be a 20-31%. So incidence of the osteomyelitis due to a direct inhalation and contiguous focus infection increasing due to a motor vehicle accident. If you find there is a motor vehicle accident and you can maybe chances to get a osteomyelitis, the increasing use of orthopedic fixation device, if you are seeing that, due to that also there will be some inflammation or there will be some chances of inflammation due to a Staphylococcus aureus. And males have a higher rate of contiguous focus osteomyelitis than do a females. Well, mostly it will be due to a motor vehicle accident. If you are doing some orthopedic fixation device, due to that there will be a chances of osteomyelitis. If you seen that joint implant, if you are done and after that there will be a some complication will be there, and due to that there will be a Staphylococcus infection and there will be a formation of osteomyelitis. So males are more prone than females. So acute osteomyelitis infants, so they may be, you can just see the picture of the bone where you can find out the epiphysis will be there upper part, and this will be a metaphysis, and in middle part the whole this part will be considered as diaphysis or shaft, it will be considered as shaft, and similar way the lower part also metaphysis is there, and last part is epiphysis will be there. So this is a structure of bone will be there. So in acute osteomyelitis in infants, there will be a joint involvement is common, and in nutrient metaphyseal capillaries perforated the pericial growth plate, and particularly it will be seen osteomyelitis in infant mostly seen in hip, shoulder and knees. You can see here in this picture, this is a osteomyelitis and this is a nutrient artery which is going on. Okay, so due to a nutrient and metaphyseal is both vessels are there, capillaries are there, they will be perforated and there will be a growth will be there and which form the osteomyelitis. So mostly in infants, hip, shoulder and knee joint involvement. So epidermology, the incidence of infection increase with the increased grade of compounding. So approximately 2% for type 1 and type 2, and most of the time approximately type 3 there will be a 10% to 50% more common, and the tibia is the most common site for this infection. Tibia, this is a most commonest site, you can find out this in this picture. Okay, so pathogenesis, so as I said there will be a some contiguous focus infection, like if some severe vascular disease or trauma surgery like that, if you find out the some hematogenous spread usually involves in the metaphysis of the long bones, and direct inoculation of the microorganism into the bone which penetrate and further which does the inflammation, and they all form the microorganism in the bone and which will be forming the osteomyelitis. So hematogenous spread or direct inoculation or the contiguous focus of the infection, these are the three pathogenesis which will be forming the microorganism in the bone and which leads to a osteomyelitis. So you can see the development of the osteophytes. This is a initial site of the infection, you can see here, this is a initial, and it will be seen in metaphyseal site. Okay, this is a bony site where is called as a metaphyseal. There this is a blood supply, and of course it will be blocked the blood supply also, and sometime there will be a formation of pus, abscess will be there, and this is a spectrum will be there which is called also called as a dead bone. It is a dead bone. This is a pus formation from here, and this is a epiphyseal line will be there. Okay, and this one will be called as a metaphyseal. So this is a development of the osteomyelitis. So there will be a sharp hairpin turns like feature will be there, and flow become considerably slower, and there will be a turbulent. Okay, so you can find here that it is a epiphyseal marrow, which I said Myelo is a marrow. Then epiphyseal cartilage will be there here. This is a venous capillary network. This part is called as a metaphyseal, and this is a nutrient artery, and this is a nutrient vein which supplies to the metaphyseal part. Okay, you can look here in this part. It will be supplied to the up to the metaphyseal or epiphyseal line. Okay. So local signs, of course, it will be a Kallar, Ruber, Dollar M tumor. There will be a red heat, pain or tenderness or swelling will be there. Initially, the lesion is within the medullary cavity. There is a no swelling, and soft tissue is also normal in an acute condition. The merely sign is deep tenderness will be there, and localized fingertip tenderness will be there around the metaphysis. If you touch that particular part of the metaphyseal tibial bone, so there will be some localized tenderness will be there. It is necessary to palpate carefully all metaphysic area to determine local tenderness. So you can find local tenderness in initial condition, but somewhat in later stage you will be finding this pain and tenderness and swelling will be there particular area. Okay. So clinical features during the period of inactivity, no symptom are present. Only skin thin will be there. The skin become thin, dark, scattered, and poor nourished. Sinus will be present, or ulceration will be there. Muscle wasting and contracture, atrophy will be there. Joint stiffness, bone thickness will be there. And oftenly it will be present with the abscess. So you can see in this pic, some ulceration or wound structure will be seen, and you will be seeing that some pus formation will be there. So the relapse is often the result of poor body condition and lower resistance. So there will be an ache or the pain will be there, which will be there in it will be there in worse at a night time, and locally there will be some heat, swelling, tenderness, redness, edema, and sometime it will be associated with a pus formation. Of course, as I said, there will be a sinus opening will be there. So this is a consideration of sign and symptom. So in laboratory finding, the white blood cell count will be increased. The blood culture demonstrated the presence of bacteremia. And aspiration, the point of maximal tenderness should be aspirated with a large bore needle. Any material aspirated should be gram stained and cultured to determine the sensitivity to antibiotics. So antibiotic, you have to find out that he is having some sensitivity against the antibiotics. So polymerase chain reaction, with the help of that, you can find out the mycoplasma pneumonia and Brucella species. As I said in previous classes, that Brucella will be there in this is a virus, and it will be kept in our body. Patient will tell you that he is having fever, but after you are taking the proper temperature, you will not get the temperature. But patient will be telling that he is feeling the temperature. Okay, so this is a Brucella species. You can find out with the help of this polymer chain reaction. So X-ray finding, X-ray films are negative in 1 to 2 weeks. Of course, in initial condition, in 1 to 2 symptom, because there is no any such sign and symptom will be there. And of course, the X-ray film also will be negative 1 to 2 weeks. Carefully comparison with the opposite side may slow abnormal and soft tissue shadow will be there, but it will be very minutely you have to see. It must be stressed that X-ray appearance are normal in acute phase, of course, but the time there is a X-ray evidence of both bone destruction, and it will be in later stages. In acute condition, you will not get a very proper X-ray film, and you will be not getting any abnormality will be there. But in later condition, you will be finding a bony destruction, and there will be a cystum will be easily found out. So it takes 10 to 21 days for osseous lesion to become a visible. Of course, I mean, this initial mein nahin pata chalega, lekin as it goes to a 10 to 21, so after that you will be finding a visible lesion you can find. So bone scan, radioisotope bone scanning is valuable in the early localization within a 48 hour of bone infection. Specifically radioactive isotopic imaging techniques you can adopt in this condition. Technetium 99 imaging we can use here, and overall accuracy of this imaging will give a 92% of the diagnosis. So you can find out this is a right tibial part, this is the right tibial part, and you can see here that the infection, the body scan revealing the hot spot in right tibia. This is a front area, this is the anterior, this one is a posterior picture. Okay, that's why it will be right side here and left side here, but in front anterior side this one is right side and this one is left side. Okay, so Peltola and Wenham criteria, they have both given identification and the criteria to suggest to diagnose the osteomyelitis as a pus on aspiration, positive bacterial culture from bone or blood, presence of classical sign and symptom of acute osteomyelitis, radiographic changes typically of the osteomyelitis, and these are, if in this four, if you find two of the list will be present in the patient, then suppose it will be considerably it will be as a osteomyelitis. So differential diagnosis, it may be a tuberculosis, it may be due to a soft tissue infection, or sometimes sarcoma, or some due to a some foreign body. Treatment, so in treatment you have to give a nutritional therapy or general supportive treatment by in taking enough caloric protein and vitamin. Antibiotic therapy you have to give, surgical treatment and immobilization you have to give. Okay, so you can see here in this first pick you have to give a rest and elevation to that particular leg, then incision and drainage, and some IV antibiotics you have to apply. So management of acute osteomyelitis, so diagnosis based on bone aspiration, blood culture, and the culture from the other septic foci. So antibiotic you have to give, high dose you can give to the patient. If normal, so changes will be there, oral antibiotic when the patient is clinically stable. Complete a total 6-week antibiotic course you have to do. And if continue parenteral antibiotics for 4 to 6 weeks, means you have to be see that if you find out that osteomyelitis it is in an acute condition, so you just start with the antibiotic for 6 weeks. Okay, so first one is acute osteomyelitis, second one is subacute osteomyelitis, which will be 2 weeks to 6 weeks. So this type of subacute osteomyelitis, it is in this is onset, mild symptom will be there, lack of symptomatic reaction, it relatives mildness will be there in this organism being less danger, patient more resistance, and it may be both. Most common site will be a distal femur, proximal and distal tibia. So in acute condition there will be a common site is tibia, and in subacute osteomyelitis it will be a distal femur, proximal and distal tibia. Positive organism, of course 30 to 60% will be a Staphylococcus aureus, and some other Staphylococcus and Pseudomonas will be there, some other पॉजिटिव ऑर्गेनिज्म साल्मोनेला पेशेंट विद इफ पेशेंट विद बी हैविंग अ सिकल सेल एनीमिया. तो क्लिनिकल फीचर्स, तो द क्लिनिकल फीचर्स दे आर पेन सेवरल वीक्स टू मंथ्स, लिम्पिंग विल बी देयर, स्वेलिंग एंड लोकल टेंडरनेस विल बी देयर, मसल वास्टिंग विल बी देयर एंड बॉडी टेम्परेचर यूजली नॉर्मल और सम टाइम देर विल बी नो एनी फीवर. दिस इज अ ब्रॉडी एब्सेस विच विल बी टेलिंग यू दैट सरकमफ्राइज राउंड होल कैविटी कंटेनिंग पस और पीस ऑफ द डेड बोन विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ स्पिस्ट्रा. ओके, सराउंडेड बाय स्क्लेरोसिस, मोस्ट कॉमनली सीन इन टीबियल और फ्यूमरल मेटाफाइसिस, मे ऑकर इन द एपिफाइसिस ऑल्सो एंड क्यूबाइटल बोन. डाइफाइसियल लीजन मे बी एसोसिएट विद द पेरिस्टिनियल न्यू बोन फॉर्मेशन एंड मार्क कॉर्टिकल थिकनिंग. So this is, you can find in this pic. This is a Brody's abscess. So this is a osteomyelitis, subacute osteomyelitis, where there will be formation of pus will be there. Pus will be there. Pus will be there. So you can find in this X-ray. So investigation. So of course we have to do a X-ray, and in that they may resemble as the osteoid. Osteoma. Do you know the meaning of this? Any one of you? Roll number 15. 15. Roll number 1. कभी नाम ऐकले? ऑस्टियोइड ऑस्टियोमा इज अ बिनाइन बोन ट्यूमर असतो आणि तो रिसेम्बल असं करेल सेम की तुम्हाला ऑस्टियोमायलिटिस सारखंच दिसेल. ठीक आहे, ऑस्टियोइड ऑस्टियोमा इट इज अ बिनाइन ट्यूमर. ठीक आहे, आणि तो पर्टिक्युलरली फक्त तुम्हाला लॉन्ग बोन मध्येच दिसतो, त्याची खासियत आहे, म्हणून ते एकदम रिसेम्बल दिसतो याच्यासारखंच सेम. और तुम्हाला सेम जागेवर मॅलिग्नेंट बोन ट्युमर असेल तर इट इज लुक्स लाईक अ सिमिलर टू अ दॅट ऑल्सो. ठीक आहे, बायोप्सी यू कॅन डू ऑन फ्लुइड एस्पिरेशन अँड कल्चर यू कॅन डू, ESR राईज विल बी देअर अँड WBC काउंट मे बी नॉर्मल कंडिशन. सो ट्रीटमेंट इमोबिलायझेशन अँटीबायोटिक्स यू हॅव टू डू गिव्ह फॉर अ 6 week, सर्जिकल ओपन बायोप्सी अँड रिमूव्ह द टिश्यू बाय स्क्रॅपिंग यू कॅन डू. This will be done in a subacute condition. So acute condition will be last up to 2 weeks, and 2 to 6 weeks it will be considered as a subacute osteomyelitis, and after that 6 weeks it will be considered as a chronic osteomyelitis. So this is of course a severe condition of the bone and bone marrow. You can find the severity of this bone. The structure of the bone will be different, and the severity of the bone and bone marrow will be very severe in this condition of chronic osteomyelitis. So of course commonest one, again same Staphylococcus aureus, and other the organism will be there. So in it is mostly in this osteomyelitis there will be some mixed infection will be there. Okay, like Pseudomonas will be there, and along with that Staphylococcus aureus will be there. So like that the presentation will be like this. Okay, very severe condition. So in that there will be a pain will be there, pyrexia will be there, redness, tenderness will be there. Of course there will be a sinus present will be there, discharging, and pathology. There are end artery branches of the nutrient artery which I have shown you. So there will be an acute inflammatory response due to an infection, of course. So there will be a tissue necrosis and breakdown of the bone will be there. There will be an obstruction will be there, and which leads to a vascular necrosis of the bone. And there will be a dead bone formation will be there, and this may lead to a chronic osteomyelitis. So it is same that you can find the dead piece of the bone. There will be a pale nature, inner smooth and outer rough area will be there. surrounded by infected granulation tissue will be there, and this types according to the ring like tubular and matchstick like coke and rice grain like feathery and colored and annular. This will be the presentation which will be looks like. Okay, so these are the types you can see here. This is a skin draining sinus will be present. This is a dead bone which is called as sequestrum, and this is a soft tissues. So this is a sinus which will be draining here. You can see here, this is a chronic osteomyelitis which will be seen in metaphysis of the tibia. So staging of the osteomyelitis: stage 1 medullary osteomyelitis, stage 2 superficial osteomyelitis, stage 3 it is localized osteomyelitis, and stage 4 it is a diffuse osteomyelitis. It is based on physiologically classification is based on a host in the first host it will be a normal. If it is compromised with the systemic compromise and local compromise, it is basically a different diseases. Due to that, there will be a formation of osteomyelitis, maybe the chances. So there will be a classification based on the Cinerary Meder classification. They have given type 1, type 2, type 3 and type 4. As I said, type 3 will be very severe condition, and type 4, because type 4 will be a very loss of bone stability will be there, and you have to do a surgery immediately. Okay, so in type 3 will be very severe condition. Okay, so in picture you can see here that this is medullary, this is a superficial means outer layer. If it is there, medullary means middle part if it is infected. Okay, so in localized, so you can see some localized will be the lesion. If you find full thickness and cortical incrustation can be easily be removed by surgery. So you can perform the surgery over the type 3 and type 4, means localized one and diffused one. Okay, you can do. So there will be radiographic finding, of course, X-ray, radioisotope isotope and CT scan and MRI. This is one among scintigraphy you can do. So scintigraphy where you have to perform, where you can find a sinus tract. So easily you can identify the sinus tract. You can see here. You dikh raha hai aapko? This is the sinus tract. Okay. Easily you can identify it. Here you can. This is the sinus tract. Ye nikal raha hai bahar. In this picture you cannot find. Here you can see. Yeah. Okay. This is the. So treatment, general treatment like same nutritional therapy and general supportive treatment by taking enough caloric and protein and vitamin. Similar way, antibiotic you have to give, surgical treatment and immobilization you have to perform. So antibiotic you can give. Of course, you have to do a you have to do the stop the spread of the infection to a healthy bone and control acute flares. You have to do antibiotic used in treating chronic osteomyelitis. Clindamycin, vancomycin, ये आप दे सकते हैं इसमें, ठीक है? Antibiotic choice guided by microbiology department. Clindamycin 98% serum level है उसमें, vancomycin में 14% है, good bone penetration करते हैं वो लोग generally. But आपको जो treatment देना है वो 6 weeks within a 3 months being the standard treatment course. 6 month का course है ही इसमें. And maybe if the condition is very worse, so you can give the treatment to 6 to 12 months. Surgical, all the infected tissue will be removed, dead and sinus tract will be clear out. Okay, this will be a surgical treatment. So thank you. Any doubt regarding this?